recently completed concerts at the Kennedy Center and at Carnegie Hall. She is a new transplant to Nashville from Austin, Texas. Would you welcome Nanci Griffith? Welcome you to our show. You know Jim Glazer? Nanci Griffith, Jim. You have a very interesting voice.
Well, thank you.
Haven't you been on New Country?
Yes, I've been on New Country twice now.
Yeah, I was thinking I had seen you there. What were you doing at the Kennedy Center and at Carnegie Hall?
At the Kennedy Center and at Carnegie Hall, we were celebrating folk music and past 25 years of folk music, and the main person was Tom Rush. And so there were just a lot of performers who have been in folk music and country for many years.
Who were some of the others?
Oh, Maria Muldaur and the Jug Band, which is John Sebastian and Bill Keith and Emmylou Harris.
Bill Keith that used to play with Bill Monroe?
Yes.
The banjo player?
Yes, banjo player.
Yeah, he's very good.
Incredible. Incredible.
Are you a folk artist or a country artist? How would you define your act?
Well, it's debatable. I kind of ride a fine line between there. I play both folk concerts and country concerts. And so I think it just depends on whether the band's there as to whether they call me a folk artist or a country artist.
What do you mean? You mean if you're working by yourself with a guitar on a stool, you're a folk artist?
I think that's what it comes down to these days.
If you've got a folk band, you're a country artist?
Yeah, I think that's the separation.
That's an interesting concept. Tonight you were a country artist, right?
For right now. And later on I'll be a folk artist.
Well, later on you got to work just with you and a guitar?
Uh-huh.
Okay. Let me show them your album. I'm kind of interested about... I assume it is your image to wear anklets.
Well, it kind of has become my calling card over the past 10 years.
I notice you're wearing anklets in this picture.
Uh-huh.
And then on the back, there's another picture of you, and you've got anklets on again.
Right.
And are anklets in?
Well, they weren't when I started wearing them, but I've always worn them, and they're comfortable, so they're in for me.
Well, whatever is comfortable, Nanci.
Yeah.
You even spell your name in an interesting fashion, Nanci.
Uh-huh.
Did you ever get caught up in that Austin country music movement?
Well, Austin is my hometown, And I started out singing backup for a country band in Austin many years ago. So I guess I was part of the country scene.
You know Whitey Schaefer?
I don't know. I don't know Whitey, but I know his music well.
Willie Nelson?
I don't know Willie, but I know his music as
yeah,
well.
I guess anybody in the world knows Willie Nelson's music.
Yeah, these days.
Jim, does she remind you a little bit of Emmylou Harris?
Yeah, she does.
The hairstyle?
Mm-hmm. She has her own sound, though.
Yeah, she does. She doesn't sound like Emmylou. Just out on stage, you look a little like Emmylou Harris.
Well, that's quite a compliment.
Do you know Emmylou?
Yes, we've met.
Uh-huh. Yeah, I think she would like you. We're going to take a little break, my friends, and then the love god. Tom. Go right ahead.
Nanci?
Yes.
Have you done any recording in Nashville?
Yes, my last two albums were recorded in Nashville, and they're produced by Jim Rooney, and they're on the Philo Rounder label.
That's good. Are they already on the market?
Yes, they are. The last one was called Once in a Very Blue Moon, and I have a new one coming out in mid-May called Last of the True Believers.
Thank you very much.
Well, thank you for calling.
It is over, yes. A lot of people ask me about Red. Let's ease over here for another song, and I think she mentioned this song a moment ago. Here is Nanci Griffith one more time. Nanci, take it away.
I found a song from my last album, and it was written by Patrick Alger and Eugene Levine.
Don't you remember, can't you recall?